Merritt, Ichetucknee ALliance. I just want to add a couple of things. I understand that ag is doing a lot of wonderful things. I worry at my time that is it going to be enough? I was at Rum Island just recently. The spring looks lovely. I got in the water and started swimming around, and the bottom is coated with algae, and there didn't used to be algae there before. I know y'all think you're doing a good job. I think if you're doing a good job, I come back to, is it enough? And I come back to that there needs to be an acknowledgement of how agriculture has changed since the middle of the 20th century, when there were no center pivots, when there were farms that depended only on rainfall and not on irrigation. And I think there needs to be an acknowledgement of the changes in ag that have happened over time. And I think there needs to be a question of what kind of agriculture do we want? Can ag adopt the idea of right crop, right place, the way gardeners adopt the idea of right plant, right place? Maybe there are some crops that need to be grown on the confined aquifer and not on the unconfined aquifer. And it's up to people in the agricultural community to raise those questions, because that's something that's going to involve DACs and the legislature and trying to find ways for people to stay in agriculture and still make money, but to grow things that aren't damaging our springs and our rivers and our environment, because then we all suffer. The other thing that I'll say is that I think agriculture gets picked on here because that's what you all are responsible for issuing permits for. We all know that there are also problems with urban fertilizer, urban water use, increasing population. We don't dispute any of that. But what we're questioning is if what y'all are doing right now is enough. We don't think it is from our perspective. And I think we need to be looking at the future. And I think we need to be working together as much as we can and trying not to devolve into arguing, but just trying to think outside the box and do more kinds of creative things. I think one thing this board can do, and I talked to Tom Murphy about it at the break, I know y'all aren't responsible for individuals' wells for domestic supply, but you can educate the legislature about the water situation and the projections. And I'm sure staff is doing that, but I would urge you to take a stronger stand into educating our elected representatives about what's going to happen if we keep on doing